Hey everybody, Nathan Foulkes here. So I've been a concept artist for animation and for video game design since 1995. So I've seen a lot of styles work over the years, a lot of different approaches to art, and I've had the opportunity to see some artists take great advantage of style and a variety of approaches, but regrettably, all too often, we see a style or approach start to be treated like a formula. Well, I'm also proudly an instructor at schoolism.com, and part of my job is to make sure that my students avoid some of the pitfalls that have the potential to stop artists in their tracks. So one of those styles and approaches is an approach that's really great, but also one of those potential formulas. Let me show you what I mean here. So the approach is something like this. Now this is just a quick little sketch. I threw this together in, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes or something. But I'm seeing more and more portfolios that don't just rely on approach that looks like this. For some, this approach dominates everything they do. So basically it's a setup where we have a dark foreground and the background falls further and further back into light atmosphere. And typically there's kind of, you know, the lone character in the foreground, some sort of a knight with the sword, a helmet, the big shoulder pads, the cape flowing in the wind. Well, there's nothing wrong with this approach. I use it sometimes, and to be completely honest with you, I've had to fight overusing it myself. Because this is an approach that looks really good, potentially. It's also the fastest and easiest approach to creating a sense of environment in a picture. And because it's possibly the best looking that takes the least amount of effort and knowledge, not only is it used the most by hopeful up-and-comers, but it rapidly becomes that formula. What's wrong with the formula? Well, color and light design and environments can carry any mood. They can be a part of any story. And what a shame to treat every single one of them in exactly the same way. That's why having a formula is not such a good thing, which for many this look has become. Now don't get me wrong, this is a very useful approach. Point of view video game designers use it all the time because it's very effective to clearly play out gameplay action. And so, some of the most popular video games use this approach where it's appropriate. But at the same time, I've had a chance to work with some of these companies. And these people are pros, and when they need to change it up, everyone there has the ability to do it when needed. And it's the same for us in animation, because that's primarily where my efforts have been. In the Disney classic Jungle Book, they set up nearly the entire movie this way. It was a character-based piece set in the complexities of the jungle. And so for much of the show, they essentially used atmosphere to wash out the background to have it as a fairly smooth stage to set the action against. Even in the moonlight, they would use mist and atmosphere for their nighttime scenes. But as soon as they needed things to get more complex, to have a different look, a different mood, well, these were some of the best artists in the world, with no limitation to only being able to do a specific formula. So if you don't mind, I'd like to clinch this point by showing you some frame captures from Sinbad Legend of the Seven Seas. So this was earlier in my career. I certainly was not the leader of the art department. That was Ramon Zeebach, who did an extraordinary job with look development And I had the opportunity to contribute not only as a painter for the film, but I had the opportunity to make a few decisions here and there in the form of color key paintings for a handful of sequences for the film. Here's another set of color keys for the show. This one was done as a collaboration between a few of us. And so, I hope you can see how very important sky and atmosphere and setting was for the look of this film. And I want to roll through with you a series of screen captures from the show, because I went through and did a screen cap of every variation of sky that was used in the film. And what you'll see is not once did they fall back to that washed out, completely lost backdrop, but rather the sky and backdrops are used as a storytelling device to convey mood, emotion, and to give an appropriate contrast for the story action taking place. So I'll just quickly roll through these and point a few things out as we go. Here we have a sky that has a nice value balance so that the darks read nicely against the sky, but at the same time the lightest lights also read against the darker value of the sky, and we have a nice focus of attention right here in the primary area that's carefully assisted by the design of the sky. Same kind of idea happening here to get the action-packed silhouette. So temperature-wise, this sky is warm enough so that the blues really pop against it, giving a nice action. But there's also enough cool and neutral in the sky so that the reds of Sinbad also pop against it, strikes a nice balance. Okay, and I'll just let you take a closer look at the design of that sky. We'll keep rolling through here, a little bit of nighttime. And the skies continue to be designed to bring emphasis to the character faces. Some subtlety as the mood starts to change. And Sinbad and his crew gradually drop into this very moody and mystical environment. And meanwhile, back at home, this once beautiful place falls under a spell of darkness. I also want to point out that even on a bright sunny day, when you have a clear sky, you can get quite a deep blue that has a lot of value to it. In fact, in reality, that's more common than not. But if you watch the show, this blue sky is pushed a little darker than normal, because something quite unexpected is about to happen. Now moving to a quiet conversational moment in the film, with a warm but neutral backdrop to play to that. And if we're gonna have some snow, why not put a sky in there that gives it a real magic? And speaking of magic, okay, and here's a pretty blue nighttime sky that actually creates a surreal contrast with the landscape. And to continue the surreal quality, a hot sky set against a cooler foreground. And with all the busy clouds that have been appropriate in other places, this is definitely not the time for that. And now we move to the very dramatic execution sequence. And you won't need me to keep saying that the skies always have a purposeful quality. And yeah, of course we have to wrap up with the sunset. Everyone knows. So we're certainly not immune to cliches, but hey, if it works, use it. And that's exactly what my point is. If it works, by all means, use it. But make sure that you have options. And in this business, that's exactly what's required to take the audience on a complete roller coaster ride that creates a compelling story and experience for them. So I'm always around on the off chance you want to hear more about this with my Designing with Color and Light course at schoolism.com, my amazing hosts. I also teach environment design and pictorial composition, and this doesn't have to break the bank, my friends. Our subscriptions run as low as $15 a month so that this can be affordable for you. But wherever you go to keep learning and improving, I want to wish you the very best.